Sam here from CreativeMinds. In this video, we're covering the MarketPlace extension for Magento. This extension allows multiple suppliers and vendors to create, manage, and track products and orders that have been uploaded to a MarketPlace for your Magento store. This extension also creates an easy platform for both the administrator and multiple vendors or suppliers to manage their orders and products, and also track sales and payments.
After you've installed the MarketPlace extension, the first thing you're going to need to do is go to System on your admin account, then Configuration. Because the MarketPlace extension builds upon the Frontend Uploader, you will need to go to Configuration under the Frontend Uploader header on your dashboard in order to enable the module. In addition to enabling the module, there are several other general and global settings that you can adjust within the extension. First, you can decide whether or not you want customers to be able to assign their own customer group upon registration. Under Presentation, you can control the label for the link on the supplier's account dashboard that will bring them to their extension dashboard. And here's a quick preview of what the supplier's dashboard is going to look like. They can see their total revenues, average revenues per order, as well as items sold, and they can also view this information in graphic form over time. Further, the admin can control the appearance of the supplier's dashboard. For example, you can show a default header and footer. And on the supplier side, this black strip at the top is the default header. And if we scroll down, this is what the footer looks like at the bottom. And if you enable it, the default allows suppliers to sign up for your newsletters. If you use a custom theme with jQuery, you need to make sure to disable jQuery in order to prevent errors. Under Supplier Group, you can choose which group name you want to assign as your suppliers, and you can also choose which group you want to be able to edit their own products. Under Notifications, here you can create a custom email to be sent to suppliers to notify them when a product has been approved by the admin and when a product has been ordered. There are various shortcodes that make this customizable to the particular product and supplier. The same goes for when a product has been ordered. There are various shortcodes that make this notification highly customizable and informative, including detailed information about who has ordered a product, the quantity ordered, and so on. So now if we go to Marketplace Configuration, here under Presentation, you can enable supplier pages. You can also add the option that the sold by and the supplier's name will be on the products page. You can also enable customers to receive an email when a supplier has created a shipment, as well as allow suppliers to manage their own shipping costs. Under pricing, you can determine what your default percentage fee as an admin is going to be, and you can also notify suppliers when their profiles have been changed or approved. Next, let's go to product settings. Here you can assign a set of attributes that suppliers can use to tag and manage their products. You can also control the maximum number of images that suppliers can upload to a product page, as well as the product tax class, and whether or not a supplier can assign a SKU number. You can also provide an auto increment SKU number. Now, if we go into Manage Attributes, under Manage Label Options, you can control how this attribute's label appears for the admin, the supplier frontend, and for the store view. After you've enabled the Marketplace module, in Categories under Catalog, the administrator can make their product categories available to suppliers. So when a supplier goes to add a product, this is what those attributes are going to look like for the supplier. Also, we previously discussed defining the maximum images a supplier can upload, and here they can upload the images and click this little house in the corner of an image to make it the default or featured image. Suppliers can also assign one or more categories to a particular product. And here's what the product page is going to look like in the store, with the featured image and the different attributes represented in the main information, the quick overview, and of course the detailed description you can write when you create a new product. So now we are going to go to Supplier Products, where you can see the master list of all products that your suppliers have submitted for your approval. The admin can easily approve and disapprove products in bulk or individually, as well as sort and filter products by various fields, including supplier ID number, the name of the product, the price, the quantity, and so on. Under Customers, here an admin can manage their suppliers. If you click on a certain supplier, you can see their account information. You can also define a specific sales percentage fee to be applied to individual suppliers and assign the supplier to a particular group. Under shipping costs, the admin can choose whether or not certain shipping options are available for individual buyers, including flat and table rates and associated handling fees. You can also enable the free shipping option for suppliers. Suppliers will then be able to choose which options they would like to be made available to customers. Under sold products, you can see all of the products that any one supplier has sold on your site and sort and filter them by various fields. You can see the subtotal amount and the net income amount, which reflects the sales percentage fee that you defined for that supplier. You can even view individual orders to keep track of your store's customers. Now let's check out the custom reports that you can get with the Marketplace extension. If you go to Orders, under Reports, you are able to create a custom report based on a time period, which you can match to when an order was created or updated. You can filter by period of time, choosing a day, month, or year. And you can also filter by order status. So when you click Show Report, you will get your custom report by month, and you can get stats on sale item numbers and total sale amounts over time for easy analysis. There are also several other options for types of stats you can create customized reports on, including tax, shipping, and so on. So now let's explore the supplier side. On the supplier's dashboard, under Settings, they can choose whether or not they want to be notified when a product was ordered or approved by the admin. And we previously looked at how the admin can customize these notifications. The supplier can also choose which shipping options made available by the admin they want their customers to have access to. Suppliers can also get custom reports on their own products, including order products and order totals. Suppliers can sort by time period to track their sales, including subtotals and net income stats. Under Orders on the Supplier Dashboard, suppliers can keep track of their orders and filter them by time period and status, whether the order was completed, canceled, pending, or processing or pending payment. They can also see the order ID, the date purchased, as well as the bill to and ship to names and the price. This is a simple way for suppliers to get to specific orders and view them individually. This makes it easy to manage individual orders and have all information about that order, including customer contact and shipping information, easily available. When suppliers ship a product, they can easily add shipping information to an order. They can select the carrier, as well as put in a title that the customer will see for the carrier, and even put in a tracking number. They can also choose to notify customers when an order has been shipped. Under Product List, suppliers can see all of the products they have added to the store and their status as decided by the store's administrator, whether the item is active, inactive, pending admin approval, or disapproved. Suppliers can easily edit, deactivate, and preview their products. So when suppliers preview a product, they know exactly what that product is going to look like on the owner's store. Suppliers can also easily go in and edit products. This allows suppliers, for example, to allow for a special price for a product at any given time.
So as you can see, the Marketplace extension is a great option to make your store management easier for both the administrator and for your suppliers and vendors.